Welcome to the Autodesk Face Robot Legacy video series. These are the original videos that Jeff Wilson recorded using Face Robot version 1.5, long before it was integrated into Autodesk Softimage. In these videos, Jeff, who is one of the original designers of Face Robot, focuses on tuning and sculpting the different regions of the face. The workflow shown in these videos is still pretty much the same as it is now, but you might notice a few differences in the interface. For a more up-to-date version of the complete Face Robot workflow, you can check out the 11-part Face Robot series on this channel, which uses the current implementation of Face Robot within Softimage. We hope you enjoy this blast from the past as Jeff displays his mastery of facial animation with Face Robot. In this video, Jeff tunes the upper neck region so that it deforms properly when the jaw opens.
Okay, and even though there are no regions associated with the jaw itself, there are these two upper neck form regions, and they're kind of affected by the jaw, so it kind of goes hand in hand. So if I open this to the same kind of extreme pose and take these regions and jack them up, you can see it does have an effect because the jaw opening is actually what triggers some of that deformation. So all that's really doing is filling in some of the skin below the jawline, you know, keeping some volume there. So we'll do the same procedure with these, just reining in that range and painting on their maps as well. So let's just take that. And then find a good value for that. And as you can see, that's missed a bit where it probably should be. It's right on the upper side of the jawbone instead of below it. So we'll just dial it out to something like that on both sides and go back in and kind of repaint all that. So yeah, it's kind of catching too much of the jaw bone itself. Let's just take some of that out. So start to keep it from affecting the bone quite so much. And again, this is something where painting this exactly like you want it might not be the best way to go. You probably want to actually do a sculpt on this as well. And you can actually get some really nice effects on this, especially with bigger characters who have more wrinkles and more kind of rolls of skin. You can get a really nice kind of folding up here with the good sculpt. But for this, we'll just rough it in really quick. I don't want quite as much under there as the fattening is taking care of most of that for us already. Okay, now one thing I just noticed, it catches a lot of the interior of the mouth, and it shouldn't do that, so I'm going to set my brush to 90 and just delete all that influence that was in there. That way it won't. You can see it still got a little bit of it right here I need to find. Almost. So we'll leave it at that for now on that one and grab this one. That's just enough just to kind of hold some volume in there when she opens her mouth. Okay, that's the kind of thing you probably want to go in and do some sculpting to really nail that, because that's not exactly what you want still. This side looks a little better. But that's kind of the process you can work through. You can get pretty close without doing a lot of modeling.